Good morning, students. How are you?
Fine.
Good. Now let's see. Today we are going to learn second chapter, whole numbers, exercise 2.1, example number 7. See it.
In which of the following pairs of numbers state which whole number is on the left side of the other number on the number line? Also write them with appropriate sign, greater than or less than between them. Now see the first number 530 and 503. We know well, however we move on the left side of the number line, left side on number line, we get small number. Left side on number line, we get smaller number, right? It's clear? See, according to the number line, so left side, suppose is 0, so it's a left side and it's a right side, right? Now see, we are having two different numbers, 530 and 503. If we compare the both numbers, 503 is lying first and then after 530, because 503 is smaller than 530, so it's lying on the side, left side, right? Now then after what to do? We have to put the sign between them, right? So 503 comparison. So which is the biggest number from it? 530. So we can say 530 greater than is greater than 503. It's a clear, sure. It's a sign of greater than. Understood? So therefore we can say 530 is greater than 503, and 503 is lying on the left side of the given 530. Got it? Now see the second number. Let's see, 370, second number 370 and 307. Now tell me which is the biggest out of them. Both number having the 3 digits, same digits number. So we are very familiar with the numbers of 3 digits, so very easily we can justify 370 is bigger than 307. So which is lying on the left side? 307, right? It's lying on left side. And sign, so 370 is greater than 307. So clear? Sure? Very good. Now let's see the next number, third. 98,765 and 56,789. Both having the 5 digits. Out of them, we can say 56,789 is smaller than the next number 98,765. So we can say 56,789 is lying on the left side, while 98,765 is on the right side. Got it? And which sign comes between them? Greater than. 98,765 is greater than the given number 56,789. Understood? Now last one.
See, last one will explain you on the blackboard. See the first number, 98,30,450, in which we have how many digits? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 digits. It's a 7 digit number. Right? And next one, 1,23,001. See the digits 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 digits number. So by which we can justify number having a more digits, definitely it's bigger than the number having a less digits. So we can say 1,23,001 is bigger than 98,30,450. Right? So which? So 98,30,450 is lying on the left side, right? And which sign comes between it? Eh? Anybody?
Good.
Which sign is lying between it?
Less.
Because 7 digits number is smaller than the 8 digits number. So got it? All of you understood?
Sure.
Very good.
Now go for the next. Example number 8. Which of the following statements are true and which are false? See the first one. A. 0 is the smallest natural number. What comes true or false? It's a false. Which is the smallest natural number? 1. So given statement is false. Understood? Now B. 400 is predecessor of 399. Predecessor means what? Before, right? Not after. So what comes here? It is also false, right? So third means C. 0 is the smallest whole number. Yes, it's a true. 0 is the smallest whole number. Now D. 600 is the successor of 599. Yes, after 599, which what comes? 600. So we can say it's a true, right? Now E. All natural numbers are whole numbers. Do you know now? From where do whole natural numbers are started? 1s. 1, 2, 3 up to infinite. So we can say all the natural numbers are whole numbers. So the given statement is true. Now F. All whole numbers are natural numbers. No, we can't say all whole numbers are natural numbers, because in group of whole numbers 0 is included and 0 is not a natural number. So we can say it's a false statement. Now G. The predecessor of a 2 digit number is never a single digit number. The predecessor of a 2 digit number is never a single digit number. No. It may be possible, maybe we have any, right? We can say it is a false. Because why? See, the predecessor of 2 digit number is always single digit number. The statement is false. Because why? The predecessor of 10 is 9, which is a single digit number, right? Now H. 1 is the smallest whole number. No. What is the smallest whole number? Which is the smallest whole number? 0. So we can say the given statement is false. Now, next one. The natural number 1 has no predecessor. What can we say for it? Is it true or false? False. Because why? 0 is a what? Whole number, not a natural number. Now next J. The whole number 1 has no predecessor. The natural number 1 has no predecessor. It is a true statement. The natural number 1 has no predecessor. It's a true statement. Because why? It has a 0. The predecessor of 1 is what? 0. And 0 is not a natural number. Got it? Now next, J. The whole number 1 has no predecessor. If we talk about the predecessor, 0 is the predecessor, but it is a whole number. So we can say the statement J, the whole number 1 has no predecessor, is a false. Got it? Now K. The whole number 13 lies between 11 and 12. No. 13 is lying after 11 and 12. So we can say it's a what? False statement. Got it? Now L. The whole number 0 has no predecessor. What we can say for it? The whole number 0 has no predecessor. Yes, it's a true statement. Right?
And last one, because what is the predecessor of 0? Minus 1, and it becomes a what? Integer. So that's why the m, the successor of a 2-digit number, is always a 2-digit number. No, it is not, because if suppose we have our number 99, so next number is what? 100. So we can say it is possible having a 3-digit, 4-digit, yeah, whatever. Got it? So like this way, you have to complete the example number 7 and 8 in your notebook. So onwards from next topic to properties of whole numbers will continue in next period. Okay, bye.